Thank you for being with me on 7 at 7 today. Today, we are going to be speaking about the power of renewing your mind. Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 23 says, "Be renewed in the spirit of your mind." I think you're going to like this today. Would you take just a moment before I teach this short teaching at 7 at 7 here? That's 7 a.m. in the morning, 7 p.m. in the evening, sometimes in between. And I'll bring a thought from the Scripture or a principle that I believe will produce faith, it will produce success, it will produce a joy and a peace that comes from God. The Bible is full of the principles of the kingdom of heaven. And you know, Jesus taught us to pray that His will would be done on earth just like it is in heaven. So if we learn these principles that are in the Word of God and apply them today, we can have so many of the qualities of heaven at work in our life today. You know, the very proof that you desire something is you will pursue it. Or someone once said it like this, the proof of desire is pursuit. And if you'd like to renew the spirit of your mind, you want your mind to assess things correctly, to be able to quickly capture negativity or fears or things that are unrealistic, are things that are out of proportion when you think about them or when you see them. You want to make sure that nothing ever becomes an addicting thought to you. How do you do that? How do you take the control of your mind like that? Well, I believe you can agree. Somebody once said that if you think you can or if you think you can't, either way, you're right. And it's really a matter of how you see things, how you think about them. My dad was a great pastor, and he and my mom pastored about 50 years. And he would say to me and my four brothers and two sisters, he would say things like this, Walter, just because a thought comes into your head doesn't mean that you have to think on it. You have to learn how to quickly assess, and if it's a positive thing, something that's good for you, then you assimilate it into your life. If it's not, you take that ability that you have and you categorize it out of your thought process. You get it out of your life. So it does not become something that can confine you, something that hurts you, something that's negative, or a bad thought, of course, can lead to a bad action, which then leads to a habit, a series of actions happens, of course, and creates what we call habits. Well, all habits begin with a thought. What if we could arrest that thought initially when it first comes in? You can't help from having thoughts. But somebody once said it like this to me. They said, you know, Pastor, I believe the first thought really doesn't count. It's that second, third, and fourth one. So there's an automatic awareness that creates a thought. But you can renew or become strengthened in the thought reflex of your mind, where you can hear words like, you can hear the word cancer, and cancer is a horrible thing. And in this past generation, for sure, it was so, so deadly all the time, and it still is, obviously. But used to, when people would hear the word cancer, they would think, oh my goodness, I think I'm gonna die. But now, of course, there's great treatments, there's wonderful things that are being developed, and much of that is being wiped out. And I believe in Jesus' name it will be completely. But the fear of that word, because it's being assessed correctly, is not as confining and defining as it was at one time. Once again, because of good medicine, and also, I believe, because of prayer. It's very important that we learn how to reflex in our thought. One time when I was just a young boy, I remember there was this big tree behind the house where I lived. And I would stand and look at that tree, especially when I was about 5 and 6 years old. And I would, and the limbs were up pretty high. And it was very difficult. If I were to try to climb it, I just couldn't do it. And I remember thinking how big that was. And then when I got up about 6 or 7 years old, I found a way to reach that top limb. And it was a great mountain that I climbed, you know, climbing this big old oak tree in my backyard. But years later, I went back when I was a grown man, and I visited that house that has that big tree. And I wanted to go look at that tree that was so intimidating to me. And when I saw that tree, I thought, that's not near as large a tree as I thought it was before. Without a doubt, the perspective that you have and the ability to assess with your thoughts will give you that power and that ability to move forward. What if we could do that every time? What if we could see our giants and think, instead of that giant hurting me, he's just so big, I just don't think I can miss him when I throw this stone at him, like David did in the Bible. The ability to do that is powerful. And experience wants you to believe something or buy into something that it's only that way. But when you renew the spirit of your mind, you're able to continually assess things. And as you assess them, you can keep them in perspective. I like to say it like this: enlarge the view of your own ability. You have the ability to think like God. You have that capacity in a limited amount. We all have that because we were made in His image and His likeness. With God, nothing shall be impossible. Begin to think that way about it. Renew the spirit of your mind. And believe that when negative things are spoken, fearful things are spoken, that your first response will be, that's my opportunity to do something good. That's my opportunity to solve a problem. Begin to think that way instead of, that's going to overcome me. Rise up in your inner man, renew your own thought reflex, and make that decision that you're going to be a victor and not a victim in this life. Let me pray with you today. Father, in Jesus' name, let this word dwell richly inside of us. There's more to every man and woman listening to me today than just what we see in the mirror. God, I thank you that from the inside out, we're made in your image and in your likeness. Teach us to think like you. Teach us to have a personal self-discipline on the inside. And Lord, help us renew the thought reflex of our mind, where we think the thoughts of God, good thoughts, joyful thoughts, success thoughts, overcoming thoughts. Help us today, Lord, and we will be helped. In Jesus' name. Well, God bless you. I'm Walter Hallam. This is 7 at 7, 7 in the morning, 7 in the evening, sometimes in between. I look forward to seeing you at 7 o'clock. Bye-bye.